The storm has now arrived. Hey guys, it's StormBoy13. Today, I thought I'd talk about, it's not weather vlogging. This is, I thought I'd come up with the Extreme UK weather event. I've discussed about the January 2010 snowstorm, which you remembered years ago, which affected the UK badly. So, today, I thought I'll talk about the December 2010 snowstorm. So, you know, like in the year 2010, the UK has been hit by two extreme snow events, which happened in January and December. This was due to an El Nino effect, which occurred in parts of certain parts of the Atlantic and Pacific Ocean, and it's basically that can influence our weather quite extremely, you know. So, so this is what I'm going to chat about. So, and this is kind of, it was in December 2010. We know that, or maybe the end of November when we know. As we know, we have had like the first section of the heavy snow for fence, which lasted for over a week, and then the second one, which occurred up to the run up to Christmas. So I kind of know about this, these events that have been happening from the snow events. So let's begin. So as we know, starting on Wednesday the 24th of November, the UK, before the snow hit, was hit by an Arctic blast, which sometimes around in this time, well, around the end of November, you know, the cold air can really sink in, so that obviously can drop the temperatures dramatically, and you know, that always changes the weather. The jet stream has been quite a lot further south as well. Usually brings in the rain-bearing systems, which is just roughly where we are, but during that winter, as well as January 2010, after it's been a mild start to November, or mostly a mild November, the first half at least, the jet stream sinks further south and each day got progressively colder and colder. Now, now mainly talking about the East Midlands, I don't know much about the other countries elsewhere, so I thought I saw that on Wikipedia. But what I do know about in the event, we started seeing some snow in late November. Little unusual, but it's not, well, strange, but not completely rare, I would say. It's nothing unusual, you know, to get snow in late November. We had one a couple of months ago, but it was just very light flurries. And even that, we didn't really have disruptive snow, it was just light flurries. But then as we approached Saturday, the 27th of November, the East Midlands got blanketed by heavy snow, especially across parts of Derbyshire, parts of North Nottinghamshire, North Midlands particularly was hit badly. And we know this was due to some unusually low temperatures, which then, you know, hit the cold air. As we have rain, hits the cold air, turns into snow, and then by the 28th it was really blanketed in a lot of heavy snow. This was generally overnight snowfall, so during the day not a lot will be seen, but then especially as we get to the closing days of November, things have got pretty ugly. We know we've been seeing black ice been reported, well, quite icy conditions, a lot of snow has been forecast. We know we get these northerly blasts or northeasterly blasts, and you know, or maybe from an easterly direction, couldn't quite remember when, but I know that that's brought in a lot of cold air, and we've been getting these low pressure systems which has hit the cold air, which we've just seen day after day after day of heavy snow, especially by Wednesday the 1st of December. There's been a lot of accidents reported around in Nottingham because of the links to the snow and the ice itself. Lots of schools were closed. Nearly every school in East Midlands was probably closed around that time when we had the heavy snowfall. And then, and also, it's not just about the snow, but temperatures from the 2nd and the 3rd were really suppressed by that snowfall event, which temperatures struggled to get above minus 2 Celsius in quite a lot of places in the East Midlands. We know there was a very brief mild interlude on the 4th. The cold air well and truly returned on the 5th with below freezing temperatures, let alone averaged temperatures. And the main thing is when we had a lot of snowfall around this event, because the temperature of the air was so cold, that snow took ages to melt, and we know that's also caused serious concern for ice, and there's been a lot of black ice as well reported all across the East Midlands, making it very dangerous. So throughout that period, it's been pretty much daily occurrence of bad accidents on the roads linked to the ice and the snow itself. Because around the 6th and the 7th, the last few days before the cold snap ended for now, temperatures were well below freezing. In fact, on the 6th, I remember temperatures in a few places didn't even get above -5 Celsius and didn't get above -3 on the 7th. So this just proves how cold and how extreme our weather can be. But this might have been to do with the El Nino effect, because that very rarely happens for temperatures to be that low. Then, throughout the course of December, for a time, for a week, the temperatures was actually a little bit closer to what it should be, but not much rain though, but we've had some spells of rain and some dry spells. But then by the 16th, another northerly blast of cold air sunk right across our country, not just UK, but much of Europe was also badly hit by the extreme winter weather. So temperatures were well below freezing in the afternoon with some snow to fall. But again, it's not been too disruptive, thankfully, to start with. Dry on the 17th, the temperatures again were well below freezing. Then throughout the weekend, on the 18th and the 19th, we saw some very low temperatures. Some places East Midlands saw some exceptionally heavy snow showers, some places dodged them. But we know in like northern areas of the England, they've also had some thunder snow, like I think in Manchester, or somewhere around in northern England on the 18th. Some quite extreme weather we've had. Unusual weather, I would say, even in the UK. They're more common in the US, especially around the like northern parts of the USA, when they get hit by heavy snowfall with this moisture and the air mass, and sometimes that can create lightning even in cold conditions like this. So that's quite something that is a bit unusual about. And then 20th, temperatures below -3 to -5 Celsius in exposed places, probably even out in cities as well. And then we've also been seeing some overnight snowfalls, and then on the 21st overnight we've had a lot of snow, about 5, 10, 15 centimetres roughly in our area, maybe even a few more in one or two places, which obviously has hit the very cold air. And we know again that's brought in some school closures. So the 22nd has been a very snowy day, quite a disruptive day, a lot of accidents on that day. It's just been a lot of chaos on the roads. And even when the snow ended, the run up to Christmas, we saw some very low temperatures once again for the time of the year, with -2, -3 Celsius throughout the daily daytime temperature, which is very unusual. So it's been an exceptionally cold month. Christmas Day was a white Christmas in a way. We didn't have any snow, but the snow was lying, and the temperatures, well, still below freezing, but at least it was a sunny, clear day. But the last few days of 2010, the cold snap slowly eased away, slowly deteriorated, so we've brought in somewhat slightly milder weather. There was a little bit of rain, but not a washout by any means. And then by the end of December 2010, temperatures were back to where they should be for the time of the year. But it can just prove that December 2010 has been the coldest December in 100 years, which temperatures were like 3 or 4 degrees below the average for the time of the year. So it's just, that's how extreme our UK weather can be sometimes. Now, if you don't know much about it, I'll show you on Wikipedia about the December 2010 snowstorm, and maybe even a video to go with it as well. So, alright, we're just going to focus on the timeline of the event. So as we know, I won't quite read all of this, but as the cold weather arrived in the United Kingdom, you can see this clearly, forecasts warned of cold and snowy conditions arriving later in the week and persisting into much of the next each day. The temperature dropped and wintry showers began arriving in some parts of the Highlands. So now it began to fall in the early evening on the 24th of November. Within an hour, snow began to fall around 2 inches, was recorded in Newcastle upon Tyne. The snow fell across northern and eastern parts of Scotland and England, which caused disruptions during the evening, particularly in Aberdeen. The Met Office issued many weather warnings and confirmed that the snowfall was the earliest widespread snowfall since 1993. A minimum temperature of -5.6 degrees Celsius was recorded in Bensford, Oxfordshire. The Met Office has issued warnings for northern Scotland, the Borders, northeast England, Yorkshire and the Humber. So we've had some snow showers on the 25th. Minimum temperature, of -7 degrees Celsius was recorded in Woodlawd. And also, roads closed due to the snow were the B974, the A939 at the Lechs, the A93 at the Carnwell, and the B976, Crefty to Grainside. So we know 26, temperatures plummeted well below freezing. Minimum temperature, -9.1 degrees Celsius recorded at Rossendale Camp, Northumberland. And then on the 27th of November, this was... Crikey, that's a lot to read. By the middle of the 20s, the Met Office severe weather warnings in place across much of the UK, Scotland and North East England predicted to have the heaviest snowfalls, with new warnings also put in place for ice roads, Northern Ireland and Wales, as forecasters reckon it could remain cold and snowy for up to a fortnight. Some FA Cup second round football matches could be affected, with Saturday horse race in Newcastle upon Tyne the first to be called off. Snow is causing problems on the M6 through Staffordshire to greatest round force as temperatures dip to -3 degrees Celsius, 27 degrees Fahrenheit. So generally lows of -10.2 Celsius at Tisgrawn in Wales. 28th or so was on an unsettled day. Minimum mean temperature -4.4 degrees Celsius was the notice on stage due to being the lowest November mean temperature since -4.6 degrees Celsius was recorded on 24th November over 100 years back. The lowest temperature month was recorded -17.5 degrees Celsius at Lisgon, Wales. Heavy wet snow affected southern eastern Scotland, widely giving 10 to 20 centimetres, with 20 to 30 centimetres in places. Thunder snow was reported around Dundee. Slightly quieter on the 29th. We've had a bit of thunder snow in northeast England once again, further accumulations 10 to 15 centimetres. Virtue of -15 Celsius altitude here, the Scottish Islands, that's quite incredible. We're not quite into December around that time. Then in December 2000, this is when things really kicked. -21.1 degrees Celsius, again, same place. Band of snow moving north, Lincolnshire, Nottinghamshire, South and West Yorkshire, giving significant accumulations here. Third frequent heavy snow showers, North East England and Eastern Scotland. Up to 40 centimetres of snow was recorded in Nottingham and Sheffield. 20 centimetres of fresh snow in Mansfield. And then during the night on the 1st to 2nd of December, an extremely heavy belt of snow affected southern England. Heavy and persistent snow starts falling on the south coast around 8 p.m. and on the morning of 2nd of December. I don't think we didn't have as much snow. We did have much snow on the 2nd. On the 3rd, an all-time record low of -17.9 degrees Celsius recorded at Eye of Leaming. Then on the 6th, heavy snowfall in the central belt of Scotland led to the closure of the M8, as we can see it clearly, M8 motorway for 2 days, with hundreds of motorists stranded overnight. The resulting political fuel led to the resignation of Scottish Minister for Transport, Stuart Stevenson. Then we had a milder northwesterly winds, initiated a rapid thaw. This was to be a sudden end to a dramatic cold spell for most, until a return later in the month. Then on the 16th, no, we had some on the 15th, but on the 16th, the cold front moved southwards across the UK, passing Northern Ireland and Northern England during the morning into midday, reaching central and then southern parts of the UK during the afternoon and into the evening. However, relatively little snow actually settled across most of the UK due to the short-lived nature of the snow shower associated with the front. Northern Scotland did receive upwards of 30 centimetres of snow during the day, resulting in many school closures and disruption to transport. So unsettled on the 17th. The 18th, overnight snow showers, band of snow organised itself over the West Midlands during the day, so to 10-15 centimetres for shopshops around Coventry, the M5 was gridlocked and shops in the Birmingham area closed early on the last Saturday before Christmas. A number of passengers travelling by coach had to spend a night at Birmingham coach station due to not only coaches from onwards destinations been able to depart and arrive Birmingham, but also widespread disruptions, train service making onwards alternatives impossible. Snow also fell off to the southeast, including London and Oxfordshire, with Heathrow Airport closing its runways for a time leading to long delays. On one of the busiest Christmas shopping day season, Ben's Cross Shopping Centre was closed. Overnight temperatures plunged to as low as -8 Celsius past southeast England and Greater London. Then on the 19th, minimum temperature of -19.6 Celsius was recorded in the Shropshire. Heathrow Airport continues to affect early 20 flights from a scheduled 1 o'clock takeoff. Heavy snow affecting North East England, 10 to 15 centimetres in South Northumberland. Minimum temperature -17.6 Celsius was recorded at Castledirk. A new record for North Ireland, -19.6 Celsius was recorded at Chisholm, Buckinghamshire. 21st, Dublin airports and City of Derry Airport was forced to fully close. The band of snow dumped several more centimetres over an air stretch from North Wales, past Cheshire, Shropshire, Staffordshire, and into the West Midlands by the morning of the 22nd. Only 3 days after breaking the record minimum of Northern Ireland, Castledirk broke the record again for low of -18.7 degrees Celsius. Further snow showers affected North East England. Fresh accumulations only reached around 5 centimetres. 24th, it was decided to cancel the 27th, Magna League meeting with Leinster at Ulster's Ravenhill pitch froze under heavy snow. Both Northern and Southern Ireland were under heavy snow. 63 centimetres of light snow was reported at Beenmore, Aberdeenshire. And then snow, Christmas Day, fell in many parts of Scotland, giving the country two consecutive white Christmases. Fionn as well, elongated as a morning star, provided a bright Christmas star. It was also the coldest Christmas day, not surprisingly, with a central temperature minus 5.9 degrees Celsius since Christmas Day 1830. Then things, by the 28th, when the snow eventually melted, there's been bursts pubs from Northern Ireland. So there was alternative supplies for reservoirs in order to keep out of the crisis, which some properties had been without supplies since before Christmas. Alright, hope you enjoyed these clips, and again, I hope this was a good video for you. Hopefully, I can get some subscribers from this video. Press this subscribe button on there. Well, no, on the website, can't get links on there. Just subscribe if you want to see any more content. Want me to do any global weather forecasting? More than welcome to comment, guys. Comment below. If you want me to do any more extreme UK weather events? Comment below. And if you what seventh episode you want me to do for weather vlogging? Comment below. Hopefully, I can get some answers out of this. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed this Extreme UK Weather Events episode. Well, not episodes, just a video. Like, comment, subscribe, and the storm is now out. And don't go away. This weekend, I'm going to be doing What Strong Boy 13 Does in the Spring. Yep, I've finally done the final season of summer, autumn, winter. We're now going to spring. And I've got it all planned out, so do not miss this.